Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Rama Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Rama, Rama, Rama. Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Thank you.
Sankirtan Yagya ki
Jai
Salinis Kadamba Kanana Swami Raj ki Shri Prabhupada ki
Jai
Gaur Premanandi
Hari Hari Bo Hare Krishna dear devotees. Thank you everyone for coming today to honor the Vyasa-Puja of His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj. Thanks for coming, you know, although it's very hot, everyone makes endeavor. I was just thinking, because we're sitting here, I think it's very fitting that we today are sitting here in the Prabhupada Samadhi. As many of you know, Kadamba Kanana Maharaj was very much involved in building this Prabhupada Samadhi. We're sitting kind of under the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. And it's very hot, but I think Maharaj, in his all these years of constructing this building, he had to also endure a lot of heat, I guess, here in India, in Mayapur. So, usually we have a very small Vyasa-Puja, just disciples amongst ourselves. But we felt that now is the time to open up, that more devotees can participate and take part in the Vyasa-Puja of Kadamba Kanana Swami and to honor his legacy. And yeah, we will go through, you know, some disciples will read the offerings and the appreciation for Maharaj. But first I would like to ask His Holiness Bhakti Raghav Maharaj. He was very kind to come today. Maybe you can speak some opening words about Maharaj and your, you know, maybe have some short leelas with him. So please, we would like to ask you first to speak. Would you like to come up? Just sit on a chair or?
Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gananjana Shalakaya Daksuran Velitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamahyam Dadati Swapanantikam Namaum Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristhaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swamin Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Dai Shri Prabhupada ki Dai His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj ki I only came to know a few days ago that today was a special day for the disciples of His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj. Actually, I know very few of the disciples of Maharaj. And although we have a very big society, International Society for Krishna Consciousness, and although I was in Mayapur also many years, I did not interact so much with His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj, although I do recall his, before taking to sannyas ashram in Vrindavan, very much involved. And over the years, our path never really crossed, but I kept observing and seeing his wonderful preaching activities. Actually, my connection with all of you is through, you know, it's like in India, the concept of extended family still there, but previously was much more prevalent. And we know how devotees of different spiritual masters kind of like interact. So I happen to have a spiritual son from Indonesia who's married to a spiritual daughter of His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj, Induleka Mataji. So she is my link or connection with all of you, I suppose, as a spiritual daughter-in-law, I suppose. Maharaj, actually, today, of course, is his, you know, Abhirbhav Tithi, appearance day. But we all know that just a few days back, it was his disappearance day in Vrindavan. I did not have the good fortune when Srila Prabhupada was physically present to be in Vrindavan when Prabhupada passed away. But I came to know, as all of you did, quite some months before that Maharaj was going to be leaving. He announced it, of course, to all of his disciples and to the whole Society of Krishna Consciousness. And to me, I just wanted to share this actually with you because it's something naturally quite close to my heart. I found a very wonderful parallel, and I'm sure many of you have as well, between his departure in Vrindavan Dham and Srila Prabhupada's departure. I was in Mayapur actually serving. I had come to Mayapur in 1976. I was serving in the DT worship department with Jananivas Prabhu, Pankajangri Prabhu, and other devotees. And of course, anyone who was around at that time, probably not many here in the room or in the hall, but you know, during the time going back in those days, whoever joined, it was really, I would say, intense, the whole Krishna consciousness movement, and wherever Srila Prabhupada went, and everything actually in connection with Krishna consciousness, which is very, very intense. So I was in Mayapur, and the news came, of course, Srila Prabhupada's leaving. Before that, there was a whole drama, Prabhupada not going, Prabhupada going, Prabhupada deciding on the plea of his disciples to stay. But I remember vividly, I was in the Pujari room actually when the news came, and although naturally it's very heartbreaking for a disciple to lose one's spiritual master. I felt a great feeling of joy, actually, in seeing, in observing, and in understanding how Srila Prabhupada was already glorious, as we all know, by his wonderful, unparalleled preaching activities all over the world, and the manner in which he left the place, Vrindavan Dham, surrounded by all of his disciples, was, to me, a real... I was already convinced, but it was a further confirmation that Krishna consciousness, and especially that ideal person, our founder Acharya, left in such an exemplary manner. I could understand that His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj, who was also very, very active in preaching activities, intimately connected with both Sridhar Mayapur and Vrindavan Dham, and traveling all over the world, inspiring so many devotees, his wonderful kirtans, so many wonderful qualities. So his passing, his the way, because I was hearing, it's always nice. That's one of the reasons I came also to this program. It's always nice to hear from disciples in terms of their either interaction or their realizations. I'll share with you, I won't take too much time actually, but I'm one of the probably many disciples, because you know, those who came after Prabhupada's, let's say, physical departure are under the impression, maybe not everyone, but many, that all of the Prabhupada disciples had so much of interaction with Srila Prabhupada. We know that Prabhupada himself had met his spiritual master only a few times. I'm one of the many probably disciples who never, of course I saw Srila Prabhupada, I was initiated by Srila Prabhupada, but I never spoke to Srila Prabhupada, he never spoke to me, I never wrote to Srila Prabhupada, I never went on a morning walk with Srila Prabhupada. And of course, this is where very important lesson, especially for disciples. I mean, I was in the movement maybe 3 years. I joined in 74, was initiated the same year. So in 77, that's, I mean, Prabhupada, interaction with Prabhupada was very less. But the real interaction, and that's especially most important for disciples when the spiritual master is no longer physically present, is how we can imbibe and really take to heart the instructions that he has given. The Vani, as we have all heard from Srila Prabhupada. Vapu is of course wonderful, and whenever that opportunity is there, we should take advantage. But our acharyas explain how even more important than Vapu is the Vani. The test comes actually when the spiritual master is no longer present. How we can fulfill his desires, how we can understand actually his mood, his mentality. We are a continuing, expanding society. More and more of the direct disciples of Srila Prabhupada are, you know, within the next few years, it will be rare to even see. And one day will come where they will no longer be Prabhupada disciples. So for generations to come, very important to commemorate both the Abhirbhavtiti and Tirubhavtiti of personalities who have dedicated their lives. Kadamba Kanana Maharaj is one of those persons. I mean, to me, it was similar to my experience with Srila Prabhupada leaving in 1977. The confirmation, you know, the confirmation of his commitment, his dedication, his full surrender to the mission of Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada explains how enthusiasm comes by inspiration. When we are inspired, either by an individual, or by a movement, or by a philosophy of Krishna consciousness should be inspiring to all of us because it covers everything. And Srila Prabhupada, both directly and through his disciples and grand disciples, grand disciples, and it will continue on for the next 10,000 years, there's immense service to be taken up. And this is how we actually can receive the mercy of the Vaishnava Acharyas. That is how we can receive the mercy of our spiritual master or spiritual masters by nicely engaging ourselves in their service, whether they are physically present or not. So I'm very happy to have received the invitation to attend today's program to commemorate Maharaja's appearance. And I just want to convey to all of you who are his disciples to kindly continue in your respective services to take up the very ideal, exemplary lifestyle, mood, and various services that Maharaj took up during his career, his days of service within the Krishna consciousness movement. Maharaj will definitely remain an inspiration for not only his disciples, but for all other members of the Krishna consciousness movement. That is my humble request and humble prayer to all of you. You are very fortunate to have had a personality who really gave his all out, as we say, fully to Srila Prabhupada's mission, and who carried that conviction in a most ideal and exemplary manner to the last moment of his physical presence here, or there actually, in Vrindavan Dham. So thank you all very much, and I will allow other devotees to make their respective presentations. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama. Rama Rama. Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Jai Shri Prabhupada ki.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So next I would like to ask Urugaya Prabhuji. Urugaya and maybe Lalita Kund to come next and say a few words. They are from Australia, Urugaya, and Mauritius. As we know, Maharaj was preaching in many, many countries, and I think we're representing quite a lot of here, actually, even amongst the disciples. So I'm happy that we have at least one from Australia.
Hare Krishna. Gurave Gaurachandraya Radhikaya Tadale Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo Namaha. Hare Krishna. Yeah, Shishimad Kadamba Kanana Swami Maharaj, he was an extraordinary, wonderful Vaishnava. And some of us may have experienced that in our own subjective ways. I remember it's echoing in my head. Ram Roy Prabhu, one nice devotee from New York, he said, "You don't know what you have until it's gone." And I very much feel like this with Kadamba Kanana Maharaj, because after his departure, at least for me, it became very clear all the things that he'd given me and all the things that he said started to open up. Whereas before, maybe it was just something that I'd heard or some exchange that I'd had with him, but it never really opened. So we don't know what we've got till it's gone. That was my experience with Marge. Of course, I think for all of us, especially disciples, we saw how he really sacrificed himself to give us energy and attention whenever we needed it, in a kind of inconceivable, extraordinary way. At least, I don't know about all of you, but for myself, just to stay on top of my life means my sadhana, you know, my spiritual practices, and then dealing with the world and the responsibilities that come with that already is almost impossible. But we see Maharaj, not only was he, you know, courageously going forward in his own spiritual life through very strictly, you know, rising early, chanting, you know, ruthlessly, staunchly sticking to his sadhana. But on top of that, he was dealing with all of us individually, with all of our pretty insignificant issues in the scheme of things. So he was extraordinary. I remember some years back, I was with him. We went together to South India. And he didn't really have any, his health was not good. My health was also not good. And we had every excuse to kind of like take it easy and just like rest, sleep a little bit. But every day he's getting up like 3 a.m, no excuses. And I also had to get up. It's my spiritual master, I had to like also follow. So like this, so many examples are there of Maharaj just sacrificing himself for the benefit of others. So personal, so loving, so sacrificing. I don't really want to speak about myself so much, but Maharaj, he was saying he liked to hear the experiences of the disciples. Maharaj, the first time I met him, he was, I was very new to Krishna consciousness, maybe 3 months. I'd been living with the devotees. And I'd met 2 other initiating spiritual masters up to this point. But the first time I met Maharaj, I didn't even know he was like a sannyasi or a guru or anything. We were coming up the stairs of the ashram and he was just like sitting on the floor with no cushion, just like on his computer, like doing something. And one of the devotees I was with, he like saw Maharaj, he like paid obeisances, and I was like, okay, I don't know who you are, but whatever. And he was like super relaxed, very like, just down to earth. Oh, you're coming back from books. How was it? I was really inspired by this person. He's like so just cool. And I think Maharaj, he really wanted to have this mood of being accessible. He didn't want to create this barrier between him and the people. He wanted to be amongst the people and interact with the people. And I think that's a very unique thing in Krishna consciousness, because it's easy to become, how to say, detached from this worldly things. But Maharaj, he was very personful, always giving time, always giving energy, always like holding the hand. And I had this experience that he was with me all the time in my life. Pretty much right up until I got married, actually. And then he kind of disappeared from my life. Because he knew I'm in good hands now. But actually, I remember at the time, this was a little bit strange because Maharaj was always there for me. He was always like speaking to me, replying to me, talking to me all the time, like all the time, which I don't know, it was kind of unique. And then at one stage, he just like disappeared. And like I was saying in the beginning, we don't know what we've got till it's gone, I realized actually Maharaj, he was taking our relationship to the next level, where he made me really strong in the sense that my relationship with him is not dependent on just him being there, him replying to my messages, him replying to my emails, him answering my calls, him dealing with my problems. Our relationship became much deeper actually on another level, in the sense that he's the spiritual master and a representative of Krishna. That, you know, even though he may not physically be here, he's actually very much here. And I had this experience after Maharaj left that actually for me it was almost like, okay, it's painful. The experience was painful and also mystical, but for me it was kind of like nothing changed actually. Not that nothing changed, that it became even deeper than it previously was. And I understood that actually he was setting me up for this moment and making me strong. And for that I'm very grateful to our Guru Maharaj, because I can see like he's so mystical, and it took him leaving for me to realize the depth of his personality and the conviction that he has, the relationship that he has with Srila Prabhupada, with our Guru Parampara, with Krishna. And I hope that I can also, how to say, follow in his footsteps and take that depth and sincerity. And these days I'm really feeling the presence of Kadamba Kanana Maharaj in my life more so than before. And I can have that kind of, how to say, gentle conviction that this process is something truly amazing, and that pure devotional service is very much accessible for every single one of us. And I owe that to our Guru Maharaj. So I think I can finish here. I'm not sure if she's going to say something, but yeah, all glories to our spiritual master and all of the wonderful Vaishnavas. Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna.
Oh, no. Okay. Namo Vishnu Praya Krishna Pastaya Bhutale Shrimati Kadamba Kanana Swami Iti Namini. Hare Krishna, everyone. I don't know if I didn't prepare anything, but yeah, we'll see what come out. And I'm not so philosophical or gonna like, I'm just gonna say something from my heart and actually some realization and some pastime that been. I still remember the first time he came to Mauritius for Kirtan Mela first time. But before that, he had one disciple that he instructed him to come to Mauritius often to do Harinam, and he is Harinam Ananda Prabhu. And then from him, we got to know Guru Maharaj. And he was only just telling us about like how Guru Maharaj is just very enthusiastic in kirtan. And then we were just hearing his kirtan every day. And somehow or other, we were like, oh, we hope that one day he comes to Mauritius. And then Kirtan Mela finally came 2015, and he came to Mauritius. And then he had this like really little cute Giriraj that we ever saw in our life. And then we were like having the opportunity to like actually serve Giriraj. And then we like take some offering. We just like going, running to his room and then trying to like, you know, get the offering done. And then just by seeing Giriraj, I was like, oh, maybe Giriraj is giving me the little like hint that maybe this personality will be in my life forever. And then after so many years just associating with Guru Maharaj, somehow or other I got to do a service to like actually organize a small kirtan on the beach for him. And then my father was just pushing me to like, you know, make it big, because it's Kadamba Kanana Swami. How can you make a small kirtan? And I was like, but if we make it big, we need to like get permission. We need a sound system. We need like a whole setup. And I don't think this is possible. And then he was like, no, let's just do it. I'll do the prasadam, you take care of all the other stuff. And I was like, okay. And then I end up trying to get a permission from the government, the beach authority, for doing this kirtan. And somehow or other, it's just messed up. everything was messed up. I didn't find the place where the office was, their location was changed. I was calling them and they were not replying. It was like, you know, 12 o'clock, and then 12 o'clock they take lunch. It was just a messed up. It was so messed up. And then the program was supposed to happen on Saturday. And it was like, on top of that, it was like a public holiday. So the electrician people who were supposed to take electric from the big pillar to like a small a PowerPoint. And then it was just, again, it was like not working. We were like calling them. We were like, please, where are you? We need your help. They're putting me on like customer care. And then customer care is just like a lady speaking. And then I have to press one, press two. And Guru Maharaj is already there on the program. And there's no electric. There is like no sound system. There's nothing. And I'm just like, Krishna, what can I do? I don't know. I was just like freaking out. And I was like, okay, it's Krishna's arrangement. And then after the whole thing happened, everything was really blissful. Guru Maharaj was like really happy. The program went really nice. Prasadam was nice. And it started raining in the middle of the kirtan. And then Guru Maharaj, after the kirtan, he like actually said, that was really nice because the rain bring all the people under one roof. And because everyone after like 2 hours, they were like, actually like, oh, let's just sit there. Let's just like, you know, go on the beach and stuff. But nobody was like actually being the kirtan. So there's a little bit of like the one experience that actually made me feel that, oh, Krishna actually made you a fool in front of your guru. And it's actually true. And then your guru see how you're like such a foolish. And then he like actually give you the blessings of like, you know, being better in your spiritual life and in general in life. So there's one pastime that happened with me and my Guru Maharaj. And yeah, of course, the whole thing went so fast. And now he's not personally here. But yeah, how like my husband was saying that actually it's, you can actually feel his presence everywhere. And proper samadhi is just the place for us to be, to see him and to, all the time we see anywhere, even like Ganga, we like see proper samadhi and we like just like think about him. And yeah, this is a little bit of what I can say. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Lalita Kunt. Sikki Mahidi Maruji, thanks for coming. You'd like to say a few words, please? Sikki Mahidi Maruji is a Prabhupada disciple, and we're happy that he's here.
Hare Krishna. Getting old. Knees hurt. Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Tinamine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pacharine Nivisesha Sinyavari Pasit Adeshitarane. Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shimati Kadamba Kanana Swami Tinamine. His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Swami Ki. His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj is very powerful, wasn't he? I only met him one time. Seen him a few times, but met him. And this was in about 2006 at the Rath Yatra in Durban, South Africa. It's a long story how I got there, but Krishna was merciful to me. And anyway, that is the best Rath Yatra in the whole world. If you get a chance, you have to go. You've been, Maharaj? Or? Nope, you have to go. Very long route from downtown to, at that time, they would go to the beach. And anyway, that's a whole pastime in itself. So, being there, I remember arriving at the Rath Yatra, and Jai Pataka Swami, a few others are there. So I said, let me ride on the cart. It's a long Rath Yatra. I'll just sit on the cart. And Maharaj is leading kirtan. I'd never seen Maharaj before. In those days, no Facebook, social media is just, you know, hasn't come out yet. So you don't really know everyone because I'm from America and in Atlanta, so hardly anyone comes to Atlanta. Only Maharaj would come sometimes. So Jai Pataka Swami. So I never knew of Maharaj, but I heard the kirtan. So powerful. And I'm with Jai Pataka on the cart. I said, Maharaj, who is that leading that kirtan? He goes, oh, that's Kadamba Kanana Swami. Wow. I said, it's very powerful. I go, yeah, very powerful. Long Rath Yatra. He doesn't stop. I think they have to take the mic from him. He won't stop. So anyway, get to Rath Yatra. Their Rath Yatra there also very grand. 3 or 4 stages of different kinds of entertainment. Big stage for a big formal speech, a bunch of small stages in areas for different speakers to speak. Very well organized, laid out. And I get to hear Maharaj speak. Very powerful, huh? I mean, nothing complicated, very simple, speaking to the general audience. I go, wow, man, that Maharaj is really nice. So afterwards, I went up to speak with him. They had an arrangement. Even their prasadam was very grand. They have different levels of prasadam. General prasadam for everyone, you know, some khichdi and some things. Then you can also buy prasadam. Then they have an air-conditioned tent where you can get a menu and order prasadam, and they bring it to your table. And then they had a VIP tent. You just sit down and go, what do you want? I'll have this, this, and that. They cook it right on the spot. I don't know how they organize it. So Maharaj was in the tent. And I sat next to him, and he doesn't know me, but he was very kind, very open, and we began to talk. And I remember when the first thing, I don't know why this came up, but when I was 5 years old, I had shot my finger with a gun. I don't know how this in the conversation got to that. I said, yeah, I shot myself in the finger. You see that? He goes, well, I've been shot also. I said, really? Yeah. I was temple president of Vrindavan. I got shot. He showed me. And I began to learn more about him, you know, where he's from, all the languages he speaks. Very intelligent, very perfect Vaishnava, right? I was so impressed. Anyway, Rath Yatra complete. And I think it was the next day. It says Vyasa-Puja. See, so I'm here on the Vyasa-Puja again too, huh? And there's Bhakta Brinda Govinda Swami, Indrajuna Swami, Kavichanda Swami, Jai Pataka Swami, and they're glorifying Maharaj. Glorify him so wonderfully. I said, wow, these devotees love him. He is so loved. Such a wonderful devotee. And then one of the disciples come up to begin the glorification, and they begin to offer their respects to the Paramaguru, Jaya Dvaita Swami. I was shocked. Because, you know, that's kind of like 2006. I go, he's a disciple of Jaya Dvaita Swami? I couldn't believe it. I said, such a powerful person. And he's a disciple. I thought maybe he was Prabhupada's direct disciple or something. And I said, just see, the Krishna conscious movement is going to go on very strong. If such a person as this has become so powerful by following Prabhupada's process, this system works, you know. I'm not as powerful as Krishna conscious as he is, no way. You know, and I had plenty of time to become that Krishna conscious because, you know, I met Prabhupada, right? But still, I'm not Krishna conscious as he was. So I was so impressed with Maharaj at that time. And, of course, that's 2006. And, you know, finally social media is there. So you can see the videos, hear the kirtans. But never got his association again. I've seen him in the distance, but I didn't want to disturb him because he's always surrounded by people. So you don't want to just impose yourself, you know, all the time. Hey, Maharaj, Hare Krishna, how are you? You know, why do you just... If there's an opportunity, then you take it. Like at that time in Durban, it was a kind of a break, so I could talk to him. So, but anyway, also in his departing, we see such wonderful lessons, such great determination, right? That, what do you say? Mamcha yo vyabhicharina. You see, that great determination, unfaltering. Bhakti yogena sevate. So you rendered that service. So he was the epitome of that. And he was happy. Not sometimes you're vyabhichari now, your face is a little, you know, rules and regulations, got to chant japa. No, but he was happy also. So he made Krishna conscious seem so easy and such a joy to follow. And many people are benefited by his association. So anyway, surprisingly, Lord Krishna decided he wanted to have him, I guess, next to him, and he's gone. But all is not lost, because Akshara movement is a movement of service and separation. So, Guru Mukha Padma Vakya, Shite Te Kariya Akya, Arana Kariya Nash. That's what Prabhupada used to stress to us. The words emanating from the lotus mouth of the spiritual master, that's our life and soul. So that's what we should catch up. We catch that up. And then we can go on. And maybe by the grace of Maharaj, we can become as powerful as he is, right? Shouldn't we? There's no excuse for not becoming that powerful. You just have to stick to our principles, follow them very nicely, and do the most we can, like Maharaj used to do, to try to spread Krishna consciousness. His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Swami Ki.
Jai.
All glories to the Sama devotees.
Hare Krishna. Hare Hare Bhav. So next I would, Haribol, next I would like to ask Manju Madhavi, please come. She spent a lot of time in Vrindavan the last couple of months, and I many times saw her, always when there was a Zoom meeting going on with Maharaj, Manju was always very enthusiastically asking questions to Maharaj. So we are happy to hear from here, from her.
Hi, Paul. I wrote this Vyasa-Puja offering, I think, about 2 months ago. I started writing it because I wanted to make sure that I was able to express everything. Okay. Dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Sorry. Every time I sit down to write an offering, my thoughts go straight to awe and reverence. But then I remember that has never been your relationship with your disciples. With anyone you come in contact with, you instantly touch their hearts, whether it be from your sweet words, your compassion, or your selfless love towards us. And recently, spending so much time with you, I've realized that's just who you are. You're selfless, you're a river of selfless actions of love that flows constantly from your heart into ours. It wasn't a priority to you whether you were hungry, tired, or not too well. But if anyone approached you wanting to talk about anything, you would give them time, time you didn't have, to care to their needs. That's such a Prabhupada quality. And like you always say, you're a Prabhupada man. And what better quality to possess than that? I remember in one of our last talks, you said something to me that will always stay engraved in my heart. After one of your weekly Zoom meetings, you would usually hang around the apartment to catch up with the devotees. And you looked at me, and then we started talking about how we hadn't had a one-on-one meeting in a very long time. And I don't know how I received this mercy, but for some reason, you were always interested in what I was and what was new in my life, what new things I had experienced, and what was my plan for the future. You pointed around the room and you said, "You see, with different people, I'm working on different things, but with you, I'm working on your heart." And then at that moment, I completely realized what we meant to you. Just as how you mean the entire world to us, and we sacrifice so much to be with you and try to serve you, you reciprocate by giving us your love and care and guiding us towards the right path in our life, which is the most precious gift we can ever receive. If I started talking about all the times you cared for me, were worried about me, and the laughs and jokes we shared, I could really be here all night. You've dedicated your life entirely to the mission of Mahaprabhu and to continue what Prabhupada started, and there hasn't been a day where you've let him down. You're a clear example of what an ideal devotee should be like, and if I possess any good qualities at all, they're only a reflection of what I've learned from you through your unconditional mercy. They say that true love isn't shown with words, but with our actions, and if you really love something, you should let it go. And I often think, how can I let go of one of the things I love the most? I'm nowhere near to being a pure devotee. I cannot see or talk to Krishna. I never met Prabhupada, his guru. You've been my direct connection to anything I may call bhakti in my heart. You are my Krishna. You ask of us only 5 things that we should follow for the rest of our lives when we get initiated. Is there a limit to what we should be prepared to give to someone who loves us selflessly? This is the bare minimum we can do on our part. I pray, whether it be after this lifetime or 100 lifetimes, that I can be drowning in eternal service to Gopinath, the lover of the gopis, and to one day meet with you in Lord Chaitanya's Harinam party, where our hands and feet never hurt from dancing, and the only thing to mutter from our lips is the glories of Krishna, and where our minds are forever intoxicated with the hankering desperation to be with Govinda, your forever servant, Manju Madhavi. Thank you.
Next, we would like to ask Tukaram Prabhuji, and maybe next then Bhakti Latika.
Hare Krishna. I mean, about pure devotees, we all could probably talk and talk and talk and sing their glories. And I think everyone who had interaction with our Guru Maharaj, whether as a disciple or as a friend or a senior devotee, then they could find out his extraordinary personality, which was always personal and walk the talk, right? He was not the one who was only preaching some high philosophies or somewhere living in the sky, but he was really on the ground. So whatever he said was always very practical for everyone who could apply in their life. So I wrote some small offerings that I would like to read them. Dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. So this is first Vyasa-Puja after your departure from our material vision. I'm thinking about that there is no enough words that can celebrate spiritual master and his important function of connecting disciple with Krishna through service to Parampara. The glories of Vaishnava established in Guru Tattva are unlimited, and we can hear about them from revealed scriptures. I'm not even really qualified to describe or glorify Your Holiness, so what I can say comes only from my personal angle of vision that is still conditioned by trigunas of material nature. So please forgive me any of my illusional shortcomings. I got very inspired by you the first I saw you, and later I have accepted you as my spiritual master. And it was more than obvious that Mahaprabhu has sent you to my life, thus you becoming one of the biggest miracles in my ordinary Kali Yuga existence. You have given me quite a lot of personal guidance, especially in the early years of our relationship. Sorry. What I can say is that anything you have suggested to me or ordered, it brought only fortune into my spiritual life and even in life in general. Any order given by you was very potent and is still active like a spiritual snowball that is rolling down the hill and is becoming bigger and bigger, heavier, and a snowball that is attracting more and more fortune and auspiciousness as long as I follow that order. And I think that that is the real proof of you being the true spiritual master, the proof of you being the living, transparent connection between me and the Lord that sent me that sent me and others on the right path that is still illuminated even without you answering my or our emails, even after your disappearance. So last few years, I did not get from you any reply to my emails, but I could see that the answer that illuminated my path had always come, even though not through the emails or so. So I would like to just give small comment on this. I remember we used to go on the Vyasa-Puja to Radhadesh, where most of the Vyasa-Pujas of Guru Maharaj were held. And Guru Maharaj practically, every Vyasa-Puja he said that even if I don't reply your emails, I always read them, no? So my blessings are always with you. So he always encouraged us to write him, to let him know what is happening with our lives, how we are, we need any help or anything. So if there was something urgent, he always replied. If there was something, you know, like that you can solve by praying to Krishna, then he would let you pray, you know, until you get the answer. And he was saying that his relationship with his disciples is of three ways. I think it's mentioned somewhere in the Shastra also, that the relationship of a bird, where the mama or father bird is feeding the small bird directly and taking care very personally. So then later, the second relationship was of a fish, where the fishes are always swimming next to the big fish. And the third relationship was a relationship of a tortoise or turtle. I don't have to say in English probably. So the turtle, she just lay the eggs somewhere and then she just go and swim in the ocean. But the meditation is always there with the young ones. So Guru Maharaj, I think many of us who spend a little more time with him had the same experience. In the beginning, he would be nurturing and nurturing. And once he see that you are kind of like okay to go, that you just don't fall down immediately when he let you go, so he would make a little bit distance and he would observe and things, and later probably comes to the point of the tortoise. So, and in this way, he would take care of every one of us, give us his energy, his time, let us grow up, and then as soon as possible, he would just let us walk, and then he would turn back to the new ones who he was cultivating. And like in this way, he was always engaged in a relationship with his disciples. So he was always there, and whether he replied emails or not, the answers would always come. So the pain of leaving from our vision is there. But I know that the answers will come same way as they came when you could not reply the emails. So for me, you are just somewhere where you can't answer phone call or reply to email as you are busy doing service to the Holy Name and Vaishnavas. But I know the answer is and always be sent somehow or other by you being rightly situated in Guru Tattva. Even though I'm not very worthy disciple of yours, still I pray for that my path will be illuminated more and more, that my path will be illuminated by the answers, advices, and instructions so much that I will see it even when my eyes get closed due to lack of spiritual strength. I know you as a very personal guru, who was very approachable by anyone, as a guru that was not just flying in the clouds of His Highness, and that is other reason why we, your disciples, were very, very fortunate, as we could have the opportunity of having real personal sadhu sangha. For those who did not have the personal association for some reason, I'm sure that if they close their eyes and heartfully pray to you, you will be there more personally present for them than when you were here before your apparent departure. Similarly, as the sun never really sets, and as Krishna's pastimes never stop, similarly, Vaishnava never dies, and so your presence in the form of Sri Guru will always be there for those who will seek that. I'm sure we all will still get your guidance and probably even chastisements coming to us in various ways. So let us, your disciples, be your true followers. Let us become your true representatives. And thus, let us all be blessed by becoming real Prabhupada's men and women, same as you are. Thus, there is a way for us to achieve the highest goal of human life, the pure devotional service to Hari Guru and Vaishnavas. Thank you for everything in eternal depth. Jai His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Swami ki jai.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Maharaj, I said before, Maharaj was preaching in many, many countries, but there was one country which was very, very dear to him. And I'm speaking of South Africa. And I'm happy that Chamavan Prabhu is here. I invited him today to come because, you know, especially the African community was very dear to Maharaj, and this was very, very important for him to. As we know, South Africa has many, a big Indian congregation, and many go there, and it's, you know, for some maybe easy to preach to Indians. But Maharaj took a very, very great interest in the African community. And Hare Krishna. So, Chamavan, come. Please. Everyone knows him. He knows the stage.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Namo Vishnu Paraya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shimati Bhakti Viranta Swamji Namaste. Namaste Saraswati Deva Guru Chana Vishesha Srimavara Prasadarini. Hare Krishna. Yes, I'm not a disciple of Kadamba Kanana Maharaj in this lifetime, at least. But he was very close and dear to me. Personally, I used to call him Malume. Malume means uncle in Zulu. And I used to tell Maharaj that on my initiation day, you were there, Maharaj, with Bhakti Mak Swami, who's my spiritual master. And I feel like you're also my spiritual master, but like you're my uncle. So there was always like a love exchange, because he's the first Swami, spiritual master, that I heard lead a kirtan. I was invited to the temple in South Africa, coming from a school program. And at school was wild, you know. I went to like an art school, so it's like there's Rastas, there's ballet people, there's just everyone. And then Manasi Ganga from New Zealand was like, you should come to the temple. There's a guru there that I think you like, who's leading kirtan, and it's a different style kirtan, so you like it, okay. Which city? Pretoria, the capital city. Thank you for asking that, because Pretoria is like the anchor for the kirtan in South Africa. If you ask, you'll know. So we're standing outside in the garden, and Maharaj is like preparing to, you know, like the mics, and Vraj is preparing the mardangas, like goom, goom, goom. They're busy there. We're outside. We're just talking, you know. And we hear Jagannatha Swami Nayana Patakami Nayana Patakami Bhavatume. It's like Wagwan. What's happening in there? So we rush to the temple room, and then there's this Swami with the turban, with like a mean look, just like on the accordion, just a mean look, and chanting Hare Krishna. Like, yes, we are at the place to be. And amazing kirtan, amazing, amazing, amazing kirtan. So from that day, Maharaj was like really close to my heart. Any opportunity I had, I'd grab it by the neck. I don't have the humility of who's around him, and I'll wait. I'll go, Maharaj, Hare Krishna, you know, and then get his association. So in Vrindavan this year, Harinam Ananda's like, did you get a chance to see Maharaj? And I was like, no, I didn't. And I was like, but I heard it's like a disciple type situation. People are kirtan, no women. I was like, hey, it just sounds very family orientated. I don't know if I got the right to go. He's like, no, you should go. Like, tell your Guru Maharaj when he's going to see him, and then tag along with him. I was like, okay. And then there was a wedding we went to, and then Maharaj is like, Bhakti Mark Swami is like, I'm gonna go see Maharaj. Are you coming? I'm like, yes, I'm coming. So we go there, we go upstairs, and then it's disciples leading kirtan. I'm sitting there in the back, and Maharaj's room is like there in front. And then Bhakti Mark Swami is like going through the wave. I'm like, yo, I'm not a sannyasi. I can't do this. But I was like, you know what Prabhupada said, just hold on to his dhoti. And I was like, And I followed him. We went through. We went inside the room, and Kadamba Kanana Maharaj was like laying on his bed like that, relaxed. Like laying on his bed, looking up, you know, his gesture that he liked doing like that. He's sitting there. So Bhakti Mark Swami goes on the bed. He holds his hand, his left hand. And he's like, Hare Krishna Maharaj. He's like, Hare Krishna Maharaj. And then Maharaj is asked, like, how is everything? He's like, well, it is what it is, Maharaj. And he's like, yeah. He's like, all these years you never liked fasting. And now Krishna's making you fast. And then he's like, yes, Maharaj. So Maharaj asked him, he's like, how was your past Ekadasi? He's like, dry fast, Maharaj. He's like, yeah. So they're laughing. So he's asking him, who's checking up on you with the family? Is anyone in the family checking up on you? He says, yeah, I've got some family, but my sister, not so much, aristocratic, a doctor or something. And then, so the room is like, Maharaj is on the bed, Bhakti Mark Swami is this side. And there's a brahmachari like close to Maharaj's feet, and I'm on this side. There's two of us. I'm kneeling down. The door's open. The disciples are chanting outside. So okay, they're speaking, and like they're laughing like in their bhav. They're laughing. So the brahmachari decides, because he's close to Maharaj's feet, he grabs Maharaj's feet and tries to like massage him. So Maharaj is sitting like this, right? Then he grabs his feet while he's talking to Bhakti Mark Swami. He's talking to him like this. When he felt his feet get touched, he looked at the Prabhu, and then he raised up. He's like. Then he continues speaking to Maharaj. He's like, whoa, okay. And then before he came back to Maharaj, he sees me on the right. He's like, Jambavan. I'm like, Hare Krishna Maharaj. I reach out my hand and he grabs my hand. I'm like, Maharaj, you're not sick. You're strong as an ox. Like, you got a firm grip. He's like, yeah, but not for long. I was like, okay. And then he says to Bhakti Mark Swami, he says, these devotees in South Africa stole my heart. And then, like, I'm just sitting there, and he's like, Jambavan, very nice actor, Jambavan. So, hey, when he says that, the emotions in me as well, like, go. I was like, I don't want to cry here because... You know, Maharaj is like rock star. You know, he's got that eye, like where he looks, and then it can just dumb you down. So I just went and paid obeisances, and I was like crying there. I was like, and then I got up and I looked at him again, and it was fine. And personally, for me, that experience, I had never seen Maharaj out of South Africa. I'd never seen him in Mayapur, had never seen him in Vrindavan. That was the first time I saw him in the Dham. Now, the powerful thing was this. I've had a darshan of someone leaving their body. My grandmother in a hospital, like piped up, dripped up, non-responsive, sort of like leaving her body. That was like my first darshan in this body, seeing someone leave. But the second one was this one with Maharaj, and it was like a totally different situation. Maharaj is like conscious, the conversation is clear, he knows what day it is. At some point he asked who's leading kirtan, you know, and there was one of his disciples, and he's like, okay, he's one of my first disciples, okay. But I was getting darshan of how to leave this planet, or how to leave your body. And at the same time, it's like emotional, you know, he's like, oh, I love him, but he's going. But it's also like Krishna showing me darshan of, this is the example of how you live, you know. And I'm sitting there, I'm like sort of like taking notes. It was as if seeing a memorandum of an exam that I'm gonna write in the future for me, like when I leave, Maharaj is like chanting his rounds, he's giving initiation, he's just like super present. And yeah, I was internally thanking Krishna, because what are the odds, like a little African boy, deep from Pretoria, in Vrindavan with these two gurus, it's like you couldn't make it up. It's like no series can make this up. It's like random, but not random. So I appreciated that moment, because in South Africa, Maharaj is like, yo, he's loved. I mean, everywhere he's loved, but in South Africa, it's like he's ours, you know? He's ours. As soon as he grabs the mic, we know. It's like, even if you were on the phone with someone, it's like, oh, I'll call you later. Wait. If he's in a procession, if he's giving class, if it's a kirtan, it's always 5 minutes when he says, yeah, just 5 minutes. We'll lead the kirtan 5 minutes. And 30 minutes later, sweat dripping. And it's like, yeah, okay. Now we can have prasadam. So I like that mood with him, because it was practical. It was real. It was personal, you know. A lot of, like in the movement, there's a lot of like we speak personal, but it's not as personal. People don't greet each other when they pass. It's like, whatever, you know. But Maharaj was always like personal. Even when he was chanting in the corridors of South Africa, like he would chant like, Hare Krishna, and then he would tune it like, Krishna, Krishna. If someone was in the room, we're like, Hare, Hare, you know? And he'd chant. But there was always like a moment where he'd do like a melody thing, and then whoever's around like would like continue it, just to be personal, because these are the people we remember. If like scripture and all these things, is not for all of us, but if you're personal with me, that I'll remember till I die. So thank you so much, Malume. Isikhathi sakho sesifikile sokuthi uhambe. Sithokoze kakhulu for zonke izinto ozenzileyo. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Chambavan Prabhu. What was also, of course, very, very dear to Maharaj is the chanting of the holy name. And I know one devotee, Hari Kirtan Prabhu, he's dedicated his life to Kirtan Melas, to Sanghas, and I know Prabhuji was very dear to Kadamba Kanana Swami, and they had a lot of exchanges. So Hari Kirtan Prabhu's disciple of Radhanath Swami, please, you know, come and say a few words about Maharaj, would be nice.
Hare Krishna, thank you for allowing me to be in your circle. This is a great honor for me. I know so many of you are Maharaj's direct disciples, so please forgive me for taking your speaking time in some way. But though I'm not initiated by His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Swami, I still feel very much like He is one of my great teachers in life, and probably for a lot of us, a great teacher in life. In our philosophy, we have this term called self-realization, right? We hear it all the time, self-realization. But what is the practical meaning of self-realization? Often we think self-realization is a enlightened place where it's kind of unreachable for most of us, right? But in one conversation, we talked about self-realization, and there's two aspects to self-realization, and someone who has self-realization acts in a certain way. So self-realization could mean I understand my true relationship with Krishna. I understand who I am on a spiritual level. But on the same time, self-realization also means that we understand who we are in this material world, our limitations, our loneliness, our our conditioning. Maharaj, I always wondered, where does he have so much energy from? And I really think that Maharaj was accessing his true identity. He was a self-realized soul. Why would I say that? Have you ever seen Kadamba Kanana Swami lament about anything? But he wasn't, let's say, denying himself. Yeah, there's like, in a neophyte way, we could say false renunciation is denying. But Maharaj never denied anything. He never denied his own body. He never denied anything. But because he knew his real relationship to Krishna, those things didn't affect him. There was no reason to lament. So I remember one time we were cooking for him at a festival in Spain. And after cooking with him, he invited us to sit with him while he was eating. And he has a very strict diet to follow, yeah? Because the doctors didn't allow him to eat certain things. So it's a small little incident, but for me it was like so relevant to see who Maharaj actually is and where he's at in his life, in his Krishna consciousness. And of course, it was a completely vegan platter. There was no dairy at all whatsoever, only certain types of oils, only certain types of vegetables. And I asked him, how is it, Maharaj? How is this? How are you feeling with this diet? And he said, you know, I'm a Dutchman. I love cheese. But what to do? So, it sounds like a very mundane thing. No, but it's not mundane at all, because Maharaj saw everything in this way. There was no reason for him to lament about anything. Everything was an offering to Krishna, and that's where his energy came from. Like, he offered every minute his life, and whatever sacrifice there was, he didn't see it as suffering. He saw it from his original identity with Krishna. And the same, I feel, was in his kirtans. Some of us need some time to absorb ourselves in chanting. Maharaj took two mantras to absorb himself, and then, okay, that's enough, let's go to the ultimate goal of chanting, which is ecstatic dancing. We used to have a little game amongst ourselves. When Maharaj would sing, we would count how many mantras does he take to get everyone dancing. So it was often 2-3 mantras, and then everyone was dancing. And one time, I just being around him, because we kind of had the same travel route during the summer, so I would really see him everywhere. We would see each other everywhere. And every single festival, Maharaj would be there. And one time, I just felt so inspired by him, and I asked to have a private conversation with him, and he said, sure. So we met in the temple room, and I expressed my appreciation for him and for his personality and his directness and down-to-earthness. And then I asked him, Maharaj, I would like to take shiksha from you. And he said, oh, come on. He said, oh, come on. Can't we just be friends? So I took that as a yes. Because he carried on our relationship in that way. Of course, and when you have trusted friends, what do? You take guidance from them. So for me, that was a yes. But the way he went about things, he was really making an effort to connect personally with each individual and where they're at. And another thing I would like to share, which I really stuck in my memory from Kadamba Kanana Swami. We were at a festival in New Vrindavan, and up at the big lake, the Ghat, there's a yogashala, and he was giving a class there. And the Bhagavatam verses, I don't remember the verses themselves, but the Bhagavatam verses were describing many intricate and dangerous things that devotees can do in their life that will stop their spiritual life. And it was very technical. And at the end, when Maharaj was giving his interpretation, he said, yes, all these things are there. All these technicalities are there. And there's many, many, many mistakes we can make, subtle mistakes that we may not even notice. But don't think there's not a chance. And he said, personally, he said, I count on the loopholes. I count on the loopholes to make it back to Krishna. Maharaj didn't need to count on loopholes. His life was perfect. I mean, we know from his standard of life and his offering that he never operated his life out of fear or anxiety or, you know, reluctance or procrastination. None of those things were there for Maharaj, so he was already living a perfect life. But he said that for all of us, and I really feel, and this is the mercy of the Guru, he points out for all of us, he points out the loopholes for us to still slip through to Krishna. And he said, there's so many loopholes. And it says in the scripture, you just have to eat Mahaprasad once in your life. There's so many, and he was giving all these examples of loopholes, and then he leaned back and he said, I'm counting on those loopholes. So I'm very grateful for Maharaj for being in my life and being an example and giving me guidance in different ways and giving me association. And I really think that Maharaj's life is a very glorious life and very saintly person, and we should all take shelter in his example. And I personally hope that I can in some way in this life serve him and follow in his footsteps in some small way. And just to close up, Maharaj had a very distinct type of energy, isn't it? Very distinct type of energy. It was like the air was electrified when Maharaj was around. And there was a kind of a bounciness to him, right? There was no hesitation. Everything was bouncy and energetic. And I really feel that his disciples have a spark of that. I've met so many of his disciples, and they all have this energetic spark of being on their toes. What can I do? How can I serve? How can I go on Sankirtan? How can I do this? How can I go on Harinam? So my obeisances to all of you for carrying your Guru Maharaj in your heart. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much, Prabhuji. Next, I would like to ask Buddha Maharaj. If somebody doesn't know, Buddha Maharaj is one of the artists of the TUVP. She painted, for example, Chai and Vichai, and she's painting all the demigods who are standing around the Singadev. And I know Maharaj appreciated her service very much. Actually, once remembered, we made a tour in the TUVP with Maharaj, and then we went to the artist section, and it was like, I was saying, this is Ambuddha Maharaj. She's doing all this art. She's doing all the art. And as Maharaj was saying, Pradyumna, I know. So he was very well aware of her artistic skills. And so, Hare Krishna.
My English is also good, but I will try to read my offering to Guru Maharaj. Dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances in the dust of your lotus feet. All glories to Srila Prabhupada, all glories to Jayadvaita Swami, all glories to you. It was the greatest thing that could have happened to me, for I met you in Shridam Mayapur in the autumn of 2015. With each of your kirtan, with every lecture, I gradually realized that there was no way back for me. You are my spiritual master. When I approached you to ask for a shelter at your lotus feet, you greeted me as you had been waiting for me for a long time. For me, as fallen conditioned soul, wandering in the darkness of ignorance. How much compassion and mercy you have. Once in Vrindavan, where you came to spend the rest of your life, I asked you, Guru Maharaj, I don't know what to do. You are here in Vrindavan, and I want to be next to you. But in Mayapur, I have a service for which I am responsible. What should I do? You replied that it would be better if I returned to Mayapur to continue my service. You said, I would bring greater benefit for the mission of Srila Prabhupada and would receive more benefit myself. You wrote me later. Yes, service takes you to Mayapur. That has been my life. Service first. This is where you will get the mercy and where you will be closest to me. And I carefully keep these words in my heart. This world lost a lot with your departure. You have generously distributed the nectar of the holy name wherever you are. You dedicated your whole being to the mission of Srila Prabhupada and the mission of Lord Chaitanya. You always emphasized the importance of doing something for this movement, but we need to share this mercy that we received. May this your mood forever be in my guiding star. Jayadvaita Maharaj told us about the last days of your life when you could hardly produce a word. He often saw that you were internally absorbed in your own thoughts and a blissful smile shone on your face. Once, in one of those last days, you said only one word, mission. Mission itself has the meaning of your glorious life. You are Prabhupada man. You are a real warrior of Lord Chaitanya's army. But you also were very personal. You treasured warm, cordial human relationships. Once during Jaipur Parikrama 2019, while we were waiting for the bus, my husband and I had a chance to speak with you in a relaxed atmosphere. You said that you have never preached in Russia, but somehow you have disciples from Russia. Jokingly, you told us that in your childhood you had a map of the world on the wall in your room, and you also had darts, and you threw darts at Russia on the map. I spontaneously responded, oh, our hearts were there. You gave me such a warm look and said in a quiet voice, thank you. You let me know you appreciated my indirect love confession. Yes, you have got it into our hearts, and you stole them. Your amazing qualities are innumerable. How could you manage to combine complete dedication and seriousness in your sadhana, genuine humility, at the same time, amazing lightness and incredible sense of humor? It seems you had the key to all of our hearts. You were able to make swans out of crows. While being here, you always inspired and guide us to go ahead on the path of bhakti. And now you continue to inspire and guide us even after your departure through your lectures, books, kirtans, and memories in our hearts. Dear Guru Maharaj, thank you very much for your inspiring example of how to live in this world and how to live it but at the same time stay here and continue to light the way back to Godhead for the others. I'm praying I can become a worthy instrument in your hands. Your servant Ambodha Devadasi. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
As always, the time is running out a little bit. I think we still have some time, Sachidevi, a little bit, for one or two speakers. I would ask Gopinath Prabhu. He's very hard to catch. I think many even don't know him. He grew up in Mayapur. He's, for example, responsible for the soul-to-soul place here in Mayapur. And I thought, okay, it's hard to catch, so let's try to catch him and that he can say a few words about Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Thank you for letting me come here and say something. I'm actually very emotional and very shy to say something about Maharaj. I've been very fortunate to meet Maharaj in, I think first time I became very close to Maharaj was in 2000. I mean, I've seen him in Mayapur many years. He was building the Samadhi here. I was in the Gurukul. But I never had the personal relationship yet. So finally I was able to be his student in Bhakti Shastri. He was teaching us Chaitanya Charitamrita. And me being naughty, I would always sit at the back and I was always doze off, and Maharaj would always come and take me in the front. So come sit in the front. Actually, our relationship was very close because I grew up in Vrindavan also, and we had this Brajabasi connection with Maharaj. But in this year, Kartik, before Maharaj passed away, I was able to spend a bit more close time with him, and we would go for a walk, and he would tell me everything, how Vrindavan used to be when he came, and I was asking him many things about his experiences in Vrindavan. And he'd tell me this was this, I made these things happen, blah, blah, blah. So I was like, wow, Maharaj, you have done so much. It's incredible. And later on, I had to come because I started this project here. So I told Maharaj, I might not see you. And he said, don't worry, I'll see you. It was so sweet. He's always been so kind and so loving, which I don't deserve. But that was his most, one of the most, amazing qualities that I'm always inspired by. And when we got that message that his health is really running down and the moment might come in any moment. So that day I was feeling so bad. I wanted to fly to Vrindavan, but I couldn't do it. And I was lamenting that I cannot be there. And then that night I had a dream. Maharaj came and he said he was somehow he was in the hospital, and there was only two people, me and another devotee. I can't remember him or couldn't recognize. And we had a conversation in my dream for a few minutes. And then he said, at the end, see, I told you I'll see you. I was like, oh, thank you, Maharaj. Anyways, I really miss him, and I please humbly ask your blessings, that please give me a blessing that he told me one thing, that please give your one life to Srimati Radharani and serving the devotees. So please bless me that I can give this life to serving devotees and serving Prabhupada, and thank you.
So maybe we would like to ask to Priyat Midanga, Prabhuji. Would you like to say something for that?
my wife is also a disciple and she can't be here because she's feeling ill. So I'll read her offering. Om gyanati mrandasya gananjala shilakya chakshur umilitamina tasmai shri guruve namaha. Dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada, all glories to you. I'm feeling very proud to be your disciple. I've never met anyone with a character as spotless as yours. Daily I draw inspiration from your generosity and kindness. What better father could I ask for? I pray one day to please you somehow, to hopefully further your mission in South Africa and spread the glories of Krishna consciousness. Only by your mercy and shelter would this be possible. I have photographs of you at the Cape Town Ratiyatra 2011. Little did I know, 10 years later, your merciful glance would fructify and I would become your ever grateful disciple. I pray you keep your family close. May we all remain on the path back to meeting you in the spiritual world, your aspiring disciple, Kulina Deepika Devidasi. So I spent many years in Cape Town Temple as a brahmachari. And Cape Town is like on the edge of the world. It's a place where no one really goes to. So when I was there, the almost 7 years as a brahmachari, there were very, very few, if any, traveling preachers, senior devotees that would come. And for at least 1 or 2 years, he would be the only like sannyasi or senior devotee that would come and visit. He would come about 3 or 4 times a year. And even the GBC of South Africa would only come once, 1 or 2 days a year, award some, after the book marathon, he would come congratulate the devotees. But Kadamba Kanana Maharaj, he came there, even though in the early 2000s, South Africa or Cape Town was a really, really powerful temple. It was, I think, the number one book distributing temple, small in the small temple category. They were super fired up. There were like 25 brahmacharis, 25 bhaktin brahmacharinis. Oh, is it again? All right.
Haribol.
But after certain events happened on the other side of the world, things just like collapsed. So it was kind of dead when I was there. And I tried to do some preaching in the university. And even though there wasn't much enthusiasm like in the community, Kadamba Kanana Maharaj, he still came like religiously every year, every couple of months, he would come there. And it was the life force of the community. And he kept it alive. I think I felt that by the time he would come and visit, I would just make it up until that time. And then he would just like, and the devotees would absorb that. And it was such a great service that he did to the temple. And because at that time the Maharaj didn't have many disciples, I think he had maybe 150. And there weren't many devotees in the community. So Maharaj was very, very accessible. And oftentimes he came to Cape Town to rest. So he was in a very laid-back mood. And because I was also in the temple living there, so it was very easy for me to spend a lot of time with him. And that's one thing which stood out for me, is that Maharaj is super accessible. He was not very hard to approach, and but at the same time, he really commanded like respect. And I oftentimes would come up with like a whole list of questions. And when I would come and sit in front of him, it just poof, just they all disappear. And I just, it's like they just got all answered. They were all kind of trivial. And I just felt, okay, what do I say now? And sometimes I would just sit in his room while he was doing his things for like half an hour, 1 hour. And now and then he would just like, you know, very casual, very human interaction, really like a friend. And one time he had just arrived from the airport and he was unpacking his bag. and he took out these little like plastic shoes, and he was explaining how these are really nice shoes to travel with. They're comfortable. It's nice to have some shoes on the plane, and they're thin, they're light, you know, they fit into your bag, they don't add much weight. And he was like, these are really nice shoes. And he passes it to me, and I look at it and I say, yeah, they're pretty nice. And I give it back. And he says, you should take the mercy when you get the chance. And he takes the shoes and he like hits me on the head. And I just thought like, of course I should. And when I changed ashram, when I turned, put white on, I was away a few months and I'd come back and I was sitting in front of the temple on the porch and I was chanting japa and he was pacing up and down in front of me. And I have to show you how this is. It's a little bit embarrassing, but this is what he did. He was walking and he went like this. With that face, you've probably seen it. And I just said, Maharaj, how can you do this? You're a sannyasi. And he just he just shook his shoulders. I won't say what happened after that, but unconventional. So like such a like charged subject. And he just like completely dispels it, but at the same time so real, so authentic, and completely non-judgmental. It was, you can imagine if anybody says something like that to you, like how your false ego will respond. But the way, from the platform he's coming from, there was no such reaction in my heart. I didn't feel like ashamed. I didn't feel embarrassed. I didn't feel like hiding. I was just like, wow, he can see so clearly. He can see so clearly even what I cannot see, like within myself. And I asked him once, because after the ashram change, things were a little wobbly for about a year. And I asked him, why did you initiate me? Why did you? And then he said, I took a risk. Wow. For me, he took such a risk that you know, the spiritual master can suffer a lot on account of the misbehavior of the disciple. So he did that for me just in the hope that, you know, maybe this person would take this opportunity and make something of his human form of life. So when I had left the temple and I was trying to start my life, I was very honest with Maharaj about exactly what's going on in my life, that, you know, I'm still like on the same path. Everything is like that, though the principles, they're not all like quite in order. And he was very appreciative of that, and that I kept open the relationship. And it was because of him. Even though at that time there wasn't much externally coming from his side in terms of messages or emails, but there were like maybe four instances where he would respond like to a message maybe that I've written a month ago or two, and it was sometimes just like four-word sentence, but it was so profound, and not just because of the words, but what my consciousness was at that very moment that I received the message and read it, and how it entered into my consciousness and the effect it had. And I just thought like, if I read this message 2 minutes earlier or later, it would not have had that same effect. I'm like, how can this be possible? It's like, it must be that he is the same representative of that person who's sitting inside of my heart. And it can't be possible otherwise that Maybe one time, but two, three, four times that it happened like that is not coincidence. So this line, I saw it as a golden thread of diksha, even though like everything had fallen apart in my life, like he was keeping it like together. And but it's not just this line over there, there's actually a person on the other side tugging. Like when you catch a fish, you know, you, when the fish bites, you don't just yank it in. You have to tire the fish out. Maybe you don't know about fishing, we don't fish. But this is what they do, especially if it's a big fish, powerful fish. So you reel it in a bit, and then if you try to do too much, the line will snap, and there he goes. So you reel the fish in a bit, and then you give it slack, and you let the fish run. And then you tighten it up a bit, and you reel it in a bit more, so you're tiring out the fish. And eventually the fish just gives up because its energy has been spent. And then you just reel it in and you get your catch. And I felt like that, that he was fishing me. Like this hook was in there because I had taken the bait of his love. You know, I just like swallowed it whole and there was like this hook, and that he had kept it all together. So when I saw him, the last time I saw him, it was a, couldn't have been more than 2 weeks before he left. And it was about 3 years since I had seen him. That was the longest period that had passed without me, you know, seeing him. And I was dressed like I'm dressed now. And he was sitting already like in a lot of pain, very struggling to speak. And I came and I offered him my obeisances and just looked at me and he said, "The man in blue." So I was expecting something really grave. So Maharaj is incredibly extraordinary. He is, his qualities are unlimited. It's impossible to count them. And it is because, and this verse Maharaj personally taught me, you know, Chaitanya Charitamrita, it says, Sarva Mahaguna Gana Vaishnava Sharira Krishna Bhakta Krishnaira Guna Sakali Samchare, that all the good qualities are present in the body of the Vaishnav, and that Krishna's qualities are manifest in his Bhakta. And since Krishna's qualities are unlimited, so it makes sense that his qualities are unlimited as well. And there's just one quality I want to, would like to share, something I've meditated on many years. And it is that he is a friend to everyone. And when I started meditating on this was that I was having a Facebook exchange with a person who used to be a devotee. They spent some time in the ashram and then they turned out an atheist, and tragically he took his life like at some time later. But in this exchange, there was a lot of arguing going on, and I can't remember the details. It was all kind of just mental, but he asked the question, "So who is your spiritual master?" And then I said, "Kadamba Kanana Swami." This guy was a bit offensive to devotees. And then when he heard that, he just said, "Ooh, you have a very nice spiritual master." I thought, like, this person is so like critical towards devotees. But when he heard his name, his whole attitude was different. And then I remembered this description of the Goswamis saying, "Dhira dhira jana priyo priya," that they are dear to both the gentle and the rough. I was thinking, wow, it's like Kadamba Kanana Maharaj is like that. It's like everybody likes him. Gentle people, rough people, whoever he has an exchange with, they leave satisfied and happy. And my conclusion was, it's because he's nirmatsaro, he's completely free from envy. And therefore, everybody loves him so much because he loves them so much without expectation. So, dear Gurudev, your separation is very, very painful. But this pain is a precious jewel because every day it reminds me of you. And I pray that it will always remain until I see you again. Hare Krishna.
Hare 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 Bol. His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj Ki Jai. So we continue with Abhishek now. I'm very sorry for everyone who didn't have the chance to talk. As always, the time flies, and yeah, let's prepare for the Abhishek and Arati. Hare Krishna. So maybe we can stand up and come a little bit closer for the arati. Oh.
Samsarada va nalalidha loka tranaya karunya gahana ganatvam. Samsaradava nalalidha loka tranaya karunya gana ganata. Pratasya kalyana gunarnavahasya vamde guru sri charanaravinda. Pratasya kalyana gunarnavahasya vamde guru sri Mahaprabhu kirtana nitya gita vaditra madhya manasorahasena. Mahaprabhu kirtana Romam chakampa srutaranga bhajo bamde guru sri charanaravinda. Sri Vigrahara Dhana Nityanana Tringaratang Mandira Marjanadu. Sri Vigrahara Yuktasya bhaktam shani yum yatopi bamde guru sri charanaravinda. Chaturvidha Sri Bhagavat Prasadha Swadana Tripta Hari Bhakta Changa. Chaturvidha Sri Bhagavat Prasadha Saiva Triti Bhajata Sadhaiva Vamde Guru Sri Charanaravinda. Sri Radhika Madhavayorapara Madhurya Lila Gunarupa Namna Radhika Tishana swaha dana lolupahasya pam de guru sri charanaravinda. Nikumja juno Rati Keli Siddhai Jajali Bir Yukti Rapek Sahniya Trati Daksha Pati Vala Vahasya Bamde Guru Sri Charanaravinda Sasadhari Tvena Samasta Shastre Ukta sata bhavyata eva sahabdi Sakshat Kintu prabhuja prija eva tasya Vande guru sri charanaravinda Yasya prasadha bhagavat prasado Yasya prasadha nagati kuto Jayam Suvam Sasya Dasasri Sandhya Vande Guru Sri Charanaravinda Jayam Suvam Sasya Dasasri Sandhya Vande Guru Sri Charanaravinda Jaya Guru Deva Jaya Guru Deva Jaya Guru Deva Jaya Guru Deva Jaya Jaya Prabhupada 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 Jaya Prabhupada Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasaya Bhutale Srimate Kadamba Kanana Swami Niti Namine. Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine. Namaste Sarasate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sumyavadi Satsatya Desatari. Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Basadi Gaur Bhaktavrinda. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Na Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Rama Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Kadamba Kanana Maharaj Ki Jai. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna, now we will do Pushpanjali, so please devotees, if you can come closer. And repeat after me. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Svayam Rupa Kadamahyam Dadati Sva Padantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Guru, Vaishnavamsha, Shri Rupam, Sagrajatam, Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parichana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakam Vitam Sha Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shri Mate Kadamba Kanana Swami Iti Namine Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Guru Dasa Jaya Dvaita Swami Iti Namine Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shri Mate Bhaktivedanta Swami Iti Namine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shri Mate Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Iti Namine Shri Varshabhana Videvi Daitaya Kripabdaye Krishna Sambandha Vijnana Daine Prabhave Namaha Madhurya Jvala Premadya Shri Rupanuga Bhaktida Shri Gaura Karuna Shakti Vigrahaya Namostute Namaste Gauravani Shri Murtaye Dinatarine Rupanuga Virudhapa Siddhanta Dvanta Harine Namo Gaura Kishoraya Sakshat Vairagya Murtaye Vipralamba Rasambode Padam Bujayate Namaha Namo Bhakti Vinodaya Satchit Ananda Namine Gaura Shakti Svarupaya Rupanuga Varayate Gaura Virbhava Bhumestvam Nirdeshta Sajjana Priyaha Vaishnava Sarva Bhauma Shri Jagannathaya Te Namaha Vancha Kalpate Rubyascha Kripa Sindumya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Panchatatvatmakam Krishnam Bhaktarupa Svarupakam Bhaktavataram Bhaktakyam Namami Bhakta Shaktikam Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaura Tvishe Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Jayatam Surato Pangor Mama Manda Matergati Matsarvasva Padambojau Radha Madana Mohanau Divyat Vrindaranya Kalpadrumada Srimat Ratnagara, Simhasanastau, Srimat Radha, Srila Govinda Devau, Preshtalibi, Sevyamana Usmarami, Shriman Rasa, Rasarambhi, Vamshivata, Tatastita, Karshan Venu, Svanair Gopi, Gopinata, Shriestunaha, Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi, Radhe Vrindavaneshwari, Vrishabhanu Sute Devi, Pranamami Hari Priye, Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Shri Advaita Gadadhara, Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Nama Om, Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prishtaya, Bhutale, Shrimate, Kadamba Kanana Swami, Iti Namine, Esha Pushpanjali. Nama Om, Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prishtaya, Bhutale, Shrimate, Kadamba Kanana Swami, Iti Namine, Esha Pushpanjali. His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Maharaj Ki Jai. Nama Om, Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prishtaya, Bhutale, Shrimate, Kadamba Kanana Swami, Iti Namine, Esha Pushpanjali. His Holiness Kadamba Kanana Swami Maharaj Ki Jai. Kirtan. Yes. Now we will follow with Arati and Kirtan.
Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasadi Shri Guru Charana Padma Vyas Kevala Bhakti Sadma Drum Shri Guru Charana Padma Kevala Bhakti Sadma Pandomui Sarvadana Mate Pandomui Sarvadana Mate Yahara prasadi bai e bhava toriya Krishna prapti hoya hoiti na prapti hoya hoyte. Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chite Te Koriya Akya. Arana Koriya Mane Asha. Arena koriyo mane asha. Shri Guru Charani Rati Ese Utama Gati. Ya prasari puri sarva asha. Ya prasari puri sarva asha. Chaku dandi lo de, janmi janmi prabhu se. Chaku dandi lo de, janmi janmi prabhu se. Divya gyani de prakasito. Divya Gyan Hire Prakashito. Prema Bhakti Yahaite Avidya Vinasya Yati. Prema Bhakti Yahaite Avidya Vinasya Yati. Vedikaya Hara Charito. Vedikaya Hara Charito. Shri Guru Karuna Sindhu Arma Janara Bandhu. Lokena, Lokena Divana. Lokena, Lokena Divana. Ha Prabhu Koro Daya Deo More Parachaya. Koro doya te omore para chaya. Ma eme ya kuto kribu vana. Eme ya kuto kribu vana. Shri La Guru De Patita Pavana. Srila Gurudev Patita Pavana. Jaya Gurudeva, Gurudeva, Gurudev, Jaya Gurudeva. Krishna she namo Vishnu padaya Krishna prastaya Bhutale Shrimate Kadamba Kanana Swami Ite Namine. Krishna Prastaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Nite Namine. Namaste Sarasvati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nivesesha Sunyavare Paschacha Deshadari. Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Adaita Gadadhara Shiva Sare Gaura Bhaktavinda.
Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda.
Hare
Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, O Ram, Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare.
Jayam Vishnupada Paramahamsa Pri Vrajaka Charja Stotara Satta Sri Simad His Divine Grace Chila Bhai Charanaravinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Sri Prabhupada Ki Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Iskand Vibhiti Founder Charya's Divine Grace Chila Prabhupada Ki Nama Charya Sri Haridas Thakura Ki Prim Sikaho Sri Krishna Chaitanya